When I sit down and think about these weekly podcasts, one of the questions that often enters my mind is, what is something that I wish I knew 20 years ago or 25 years ago when I was really just starting off and wanting to and looking to figure out what really works in investing and following the evidence to where it leads, not to where I want it to lead. And so this week on Thursday, the market fell 2% in one day. The S&P fell 2% in one day. And whenever the market falls a lot in an individual day or a week, there's something I do that really helps me out. And it's the theme of this week, and it's something I want to share with you that I'm not sure the last time I shared it with you, if at all. So the title, or what I'm going to call the theme this week, is Why Pictures Trump Numbers. And when I started following the evidence in my 20s to figure out what really works in investing, what I noticed at first was most things were about the numbers. Look at numbers, look at charts of numbers, follow numbers. And the problem is, your brain has a very difficult time with those symbols. It's hard to put a pattern together. But when I accidentally tripped over a price chart book, luckily early on, everything became very clear to me. I could see patterns. The brain could see patterns. And the human brain is very good at seeing patterns in life and in price charts. So I want to show you how this pattern recognition and why pictures trumps numbers more times than not. Now, on Thursday, the stock market fell 2%. Or the S&P 500 fell 2%. On the same day, Yahoo was down 1.91% and Pfizer was down 1.74%. Now, the first thing you should probably notice is neither of them fell more than the stock market. So if you just went by the numbers, you'd say, hey, both of them are in strong positions, either one's a buy. The other thing you might notice is, wow, Yahoo fell more than Pfizer. Now, Yahoo relative to Pfizer fell 8% more, not 8 percentage points more, but fell about 8% more than Pfizer, again, relative to Pfizer. So, what the numbers alone would say is, hey, go buy Pfizer over Yahoo. And both of these companies must be doing better, at least based on Thursday, because they didn't fall as bad as the overall stock market fell. That's what the numbers tell you. But that would be misleading. So what I want to do is show you Yahoo. Now, this is a price chart of Yahoo. It's about a little less than 2 years, but probably about 20 months. And here's the price chart of Yahoo. It fell, like I said, 1.91% on Thursday. But look at the price formation here. Look at how it's kind of bottoming out and kind of cupping and just kind of chopping sideways from April. So from April to today, that's 1, 2, 3, 4 months, it's been chopping sideways, kind of violently, up 10%, down 10%, up 10%, down 10%, up 10%, down 10%, up 10%, down 10%, up 10%. Really, that's how many times it went up and down. So that's pretty volatile. That's about a 9% up or down. Pretty violent. But if you look at the price, you notice that it's just kind of going sideways. It's not chopping down, it's not chopping up. It's just kind of going sideways. And so I see this, the brain sees this pattern as, oh, it's just kind of moving down and chopping sideways. And there's its 1.91% fall. It doesn't even show up really from a pattern recognition. It's still fully in its pattern. In fact, it's kind of at the top of its pattern, looking like and wanting to break up and out into the upside. So what you see here is a stock or a company that has made a natural correction. All stocks correct when they're in a trend. They just don't do it at the same time. And Yahoo decided to start its correction at the beginning of 2014. Now, compare this with Pfizer. Now, Pfizer was down less than Yahoo on Thursday, only down 1.74%. But notice how the formation on this is arching, arcing, moving in a different direction. It's actually moving downward. Now, to me, visually, this looks more violent, even though this move down right here is about 10%. But visually, you can see how that's a much stronger and violent move down than what I was showing you on the Yahoo chart. So relatively speaking, this matters a lot. And this move down on Thursday, notice how it broke below this. It is breaking down, wanting to go lower. So this is why price charts can often, if not almost always, give you much more clear and more clarity in what you should be doing with your money. So much so that even when something falls 5%, 8%, 10% against me, or goes up 5 or 8 or 10% for me, I look to the price charts first and say, hey, does that matter? Did that really make a difference? And if it did, then I start to pay attention to it. If it didn't, I say, oh, it's still within its formation. There's really nothing to pay attention to. Now, really the takeaway that I really want you to get this week is that, you know, look to the price charts for the direction that the stock is moving. And in these days where we have a big move in one day or a big move in a week, look at the price chart, see if it's broken down or broken up out of a formation in comparison to what the stock market has done. And if you do more of that, then it's going to be able to help you stay in the better stocks longer and sectors longer and get out of the ones that are breaking down sooner. Hey guys, this is just really just another step towards your freedom with your money, your future, and your life. Until next time, this is RC Peck.